The Complete Guide on Ethical Hacking Training. How to Become Cybersecurity Expert. Lecture 1. What you can learn from this lecture. Today, we will discuss the most asked question in cybersecurity. What is hacking? What is different between hacking and ethical hacking? What is prerequisite requirements to start learning ethical hacking? Are we covering the prerequisite skills to become a cybersecurity expert in our training? What will be the scope after learning? What jobs you can search after completion of our training? What other training you can join to grow your skills? Can you earn from home after learning ethical hacking? Before I start, I would like to go through some terminologies used in information security, like flaw, vulnerability, exploit, asset, compromise, and remediation. Let's understand the meaning of these terms in a single sentence in which I will tell you the meaning of each term. If she identified the flaw or defect, she can exploit or take advantage of vulnerability or weakness in asset or machine to make them compromised or hacked. Remediation is referred as prevention measure from the attack. Isn't it simple? So now, let's begin with what is hacking? Identifying the flaw in the code and exploit the weakness in the design. Or we can also say identifying the flaw in the code and change its behavior to some other action by exploiting the weakness in the design of code. What does it mean? Take an example. We all are surrounded by digital devices like mobile phone, computers, CCTV cameras. Even in today's world, car and televisions are also coming with remote controlling features. And everything connected with internet. But is it safe to use these electronic devices? In a situation where someone always trying to hack into your machine, if we are controlling our device remotely, is there is any possibility that someone other can also control it? The answer is yes. But why and how and what prevention measure we should consider while using these digital devices? Because in every electronic device, there is a programmatic code working behind it, which is created or developed by highly skilled programmers. They have already performed all the necessary tests before selling the product into the market. However, somehow if someone identifies the flaw in the code or loophole in coding, to enter into it and make some unnecessary changes in the code, which could lead to some other attacks which is not supposed during the creation by their original developers or programmers. Hacking is breaking into digital devices like phone, PC, webcam, laptop, website, server, your social accounts, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, etc. But now, every time someone would try to hack into your asset by changing its original code. There are also some other tools and techniques developed for hacking. And most known and easily achievable technique is to hack with social engineering. In social engineering attack, no tools or programming skills are required for hacking. Understand a scenario if someone saw you entering your phone passcode or password pattern or if someone looking at your keyword while you are typing your password or when someone asks you to click on the some URL or you share your personal information with someone without validating the identity of the person in the email who pretend to be from authorized company or sender. There are some scenarios of attack. We will discuss on every attack one by one in our later modules. Kindly note, internet is for everyone. You can buy your custom domain, create your customized URL, email, and website. For example, your bank registered a domain www.mybank.com. Once one domain is registered by one company, it cannot be used by other. unless it gets expired and available for free again. Now, if an attacker will try to register the same domain, he couldn't, but he is free to register a similar looking domain by adding a few more alphabets in the domain name. Now, if the user will not give attention to the bad domain owner by the attacker and visited the wrong website, the attacker can target the user to share the credential, username, and password to their site. Or the attacker can use these sites to download the virus into your machine. So, if any devices connected to the internet all are vulnerable to be hacked or may be under attack by someone. What is the difference between hacking and ethical hacking? As we discussed, hacking is breaking into other electronic devices, social accounts, personal email account, server by identifying the weakness in the code or by phishing the users. Companies paid to the hacker for breaking into their assets or devices. And here, hacker is a skilled person with a good understanding of network, server, web application, hacking tools, and techniques called as an ethical hacker. If a company authorizes someone to check the security level and weakness in the design, misconfiguration in the infrastructure before other bad hackers do, that is called ethical hacking. Ethical hackers signed NDA, non-disclosure agreement, with the company, so what all the information they have discovered will not share with anyone and will share a final report on all the tests they performed and provide a detailed summary report on all weakness and gaps identified by the ethical hacker. There are some companies also participating in bug bounty programs hosted by other companies like HackerOne, where they pay to the skilled professional for identifying and reporting the security gaps in their infrastructure within the terms and conditions defined by the companies itself. So hacking is to break the machine and accounts without holding any ownership or any unauthorized access to the machine which done by the skilled professional. Or script kiddies hackers who don't have any knowledge about the coding and network infrastructure, but they just use the tool and technique shared by other professionals. And ethical hacking is to break into the machine with proper authorization by owner before penetrating the network. What is prerequisite requirements to start to learn ethical hacking? The prerequisite in this training is to start learning ethical hacking is to have computer system with good internet connection to learn all the methodology and process being used by hacker. If you are looking to learn ethical hacking, the programming language is required. But there are also different jobs available in the industry for which candidates does not need to be good in programming. Instead, they can have a good understanding of different tools, technology, and cyber attack techniques and remediation. Are we covering the prerequisite skills required to become cybersecurity expert in our training? The answer is yes. As we have learned, hackers are skilled professionals with good understanding of network, servers, web application, programming language, hacking tools, and techniques. With this course, you can learn all different tools, techniques used in cyber attacks and their prevention required in various attacks. Different ways of hacking into machine with the understanding of network, servers, and web application. This course is only for educational purpose. We are not motivating any of our students to use the learned skill to hack any machine or user account without prior authorization from the owner. What will be the scope of learning? The scope of cybersecurity is very broad and different job roles are open in cybersecurity industry. This course is covering everything which is in CEH and what all skills required in entry-level and intermediate professional jobs in cybersecurity. Additionally, I will add more content based on the skills which I learned in my professional experience. So you will get the chance to build your lab with Kali Linux and other operating platforms for practicing the real-time cyber attacks with different tools and techniques. All information in CEH will be in our training, but what all we are covering is not in CEH. What jobs you can search after completion of our training. Most of the newbies and recently graduate students are aware of the job profiles of ethical hacking only to break into the machine. In the real world, this is not the story. Companies have different roles and different positions for each designated job profile. Programming skills are required but not mandatory. There are many different roles available in cybersecurity in which programming skills are not required, but having basic understanding is very helpful while investigating the different attacks and automating the different task jobs. After completing this training, you will have a deeper understanding of different cyber attack tools and techniques, so you can apply for any position in cybersecurity like SOC analyst, work on SIM tool, and responsible for monitoring cyber attack on company infrastructure in 24/7 support. Penetration tester, responsible for performing cyber attack and measure the security layers in the company and report the exploited vulnerability and identify the gap in security. Vulnerability management, responsible for identifying the existing vulnerability in current infrastructure from existing devices using in the network. Forensic investigator. This professional runs various tools to perform the forensic on compromised machine to backtrack the attacker activity. Malware analyst. Responsible for performing reverse engineering on the malware or virus to understand the impact, design, and different attack vendor by using the IDA Pro, etc. Security auditor. Make sure all the security check required to maintain the baseline for the security is followed by the company based on different compliance industry like PCI, DSS, HIPAA, ISO, etc. Incident responder. Follow the incident response plan for true positive attack and make sure compromised devices are free from viruses before connecting back to the network. Threat intelligence analyst. Provide the intelligence report on the latest attack, group, campaigning running by the attacker and provide a comprehensive report on the indicator of compromise. Application tester, responsible for testing the application and identifying the flaw in the design of code in the application before the attacker does and exploit it for personal and financial benefit. What other training you can join to grow your skills? Once you learn different cyber attacks techniques and tools used in our course of ethical hacking, and decide your path where you want to go. You can further expand your skills and knowledge professionally by enrolling in other training for each designated profiles. Can you earn from home after learning ethical hacking? Yes, you can. After completing the course of ethical hacking, there are some applications you can use to install and sign on different portals like Upwork, HackerOne, etc. You can work as a remote support SOC analyst from home. And also you can pick up the freelancing project on penetration testing. You can also sign up on the bug bounty website to identify the bug and report it to the listed companies in the site to earn money by reporting the weakness in the design of web application and server from your home. This is all for the first lecture. Thank you for your time. If you like this lecture, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. See you in next class.